Earth versus the flying saucers. It was the day the Earth stood still, the day the sky exploded, the night the world exploded, the day the world ended, the War of the Worlds. Here is how this island Earth, this world without end, became Target Earth, the incredible petrified world. It began with indestructible man and his Project Moonbase to go from the Earth to the Moon, to ride a missile to the Moon, and from there a flight to Mars, Red Planet Mars, the angry red planet. We would become riders to the stars. We would go to the forbidden planet, to the lost planet, to the strange world of Planet X, in our conquest of space. Have rocket, we'll travel, we thought. But we received a warning from space. It came from outer space, from an unknown world. We didn't listen to this menace from outer space, but after the lost missile and our lost planet airmen, we began a manhunt in space. It was the beginning of the end. First came the battle beyond the sun, a battle in outer space, 20 million miles to Earth, with Kronos, the hideous sun demon, crushing Space Master X7 and his rocket ship XM. Then came the invaders from Mars, the invasion of the saucer men, the invasion of the body snatchers. Yes, them, the unearthly, the not of this Earth. They came in waves, those killers from space. First came the attack of the crab monsters, together with the alligator people, the giant Gila monster with the giant claw, the killer shrews and the mole people. Then the thing from another world, the astounding she monster, the extraordinary attack of the 50-foot woman in a war of the colossal beast. Then the creature with the atom brain joined forces with the brain from planet Aurus and the brain eaters. Then came the blob, the beast with a million eyes and the fiend without a face. The devil girl from Mars attacked with the fire maidens from outer space whilst Gog brought the robot monster. And all the while, Varun the Unbelievable had his sport with the captive women. On they came, the monolith monsters and the Mysterians, the magnetic monster and the Twonky, until the zombies of the stratosphere finished us off. When it was over, the Queen of Outer Space surveyed the scene with satisfaction. It, the terror from beyond space, had won. It conquered the world. And me? Well, I married a monster from outer space, and now I am the amazing colossal man, the Colossus of New York. I am Captain Video, master of the stratosphere. We had a first child. Half-human, the invisible boy. He was rapidly followed by the H-Man, the incredible shrinking man, 4D man, and the man from Planet X. They're all now our teenagers from outer space.